Music is not sound. Music is actually a flow of emotions organized in time. We are using sound for this. But the sound is not so terribly important as we think. You know, in the last 20, 30 years, we had an overexposure of sound. And sometimes, from all these trees, we don't see the forest anymore. And what I'm looking also in a piano, in a recording techniques, I'm not looking for a beautiful sound, I'm looking for an adequate sound. In Chopin's case, it will be a beautiful sound. But in Prokofiev's music, it will be a particular sound I'm looking for. And I'm not sure that all the people will call it beautiful. I'll give you another example. Lutosławski, when he wrote the piano concerto for me, he had some particular ideas how to play this piece, how the piece should sound. And when we met the first time, he actually sang the piece for me. And there was one moment where he said, you know, when this place is here, I want you to make a wah. And I went home, I started to practice, and I couldn't get this wah whatsoever. And then I came back to Warsaw, and I played the piece for him already. And he said, well, what about this wah? I said, no, that's not what you wrote. This passage here doesn't make a wah. And I went to his piano and I said, look, that's what you wrote. And I sat down, the piano made wah. And you know, I sat down and I said, oh my God, how many wahs do we have in the Mozart sonatas or Beethoven sonatas or Brahms we didn't discover yet? And all these people were writing for their own pianos. And then we go into a concert hall, there's a different instrument, different venue, different acoustic, different... And of course, it creates tremendous problems. So we have to study, if we go into historic performances, it's not enough to put an old instrument on stage and try to play a nocturne from 1842. You have to know much more about it, and you have to see at first the composer's life and the reason why he wrote it and what he actually is talking about in this piece. Then to study the instruments, study the original texts, study the original acoustics and the surrounding in which this piece started to emerge. And then you know what he was talking about. But of course, you can approach it completely different. You can just take the music and play it, and it's beautiful enough. I mean, that's what most pianists do.
From what I heard, what you said, an artistic journey is long, and you need to put in a lot of work. But somehow I feel that with young artists, they may not have the patience. I don't know.
Nothing wrong with that. You know, when I was young, I was confronted with all these old critics who say, well, this pianist is not mature, and of course he's not. He's 18. Why can't he be mature? How can he be mature? And I remember I talked to Arthur Rubinstein. He was 95 already. And I told him, you know, these balladas of Brahms, you know, they are so, it's so deep, this transformation is so deep. And I started to rumble around it, and he took my hand and said, my boy, are you sure it's so deep? And I was shocked. That was the last thing I would expect from an old maestro. But when I look back, yes, sometimes we can kill the music from all these deep thoughts. And this is not what depth is about. I think honesty is the most important thing. You have to be an honest performer of this piece. And the piece will develop in your heart, it will mature together with you, and then the audience also has to mature together with you, has to understand what happened when you are maturing.
When you say honest, what do you mean exactly?
The performer has to be the first victim of his performance. He has to honestly die when the piece calls for it.
But I have a question on this. When you're feeling so much in yourself, then it's hard to maintain a calm and relaxed physique. I mean, how do you get the balance?
Very good question. Yes, there are two people in one. There is a conductor and the guy who's organizing the music, the person who is not connected to the piano at all. And then the other guy who's actually doing this whole craftsmanship stuff. Always the conductor should have the saying, and the other guy should actually do what the conductor wants.